Parishioners fighting the closing of their Soho church say it was shut down abruptly yesterday. The priest at Our Lady of Vilnius was called to a private meeting with Cardinal Egan yesterday and returned to find himself locked out. The church secretary says they were told in July the church was going to close, but they were never given an exact date. That's why she says the pastor was so surprised.
He was stunned. Well, he knew they would change because the cardinal had told him. The cardinal said the church is being locked now. So he knew that.
Parishioners held a candlelight vigil outside the church near the Holland Tunnel entrance last night and posted these pictures on the website. The church has been serving Lithuanian Catholics for more than 100 years. The church is not on the list of the archdiocese closings and mergers set to take effect this week. In a statement, a spokesman for the archdiocese says the Monsignor for Lithuanian Catholics knew about the closing and says, quote, "The priest who has been serving the parish for many years was informed of the decision to close the parish also months ago and did not object until recently."
A parish priest who thought he was meeting with Cardinal Egan about the future of his parish returned to locked doors. The cardinal told Reverend Eugene Sawicki that Our Lady of Vilnius Church would be closing immediately. When the priest returned to the 102-year-old church, the doors were already locked. Parishioners gathered last night in protest. Only 6 to 12 people, on average, attend Sunday Mass.
The end came more quickly than expected for worshipers at a historic Lower Manhattan church. And as Roseanne Coletti tells us, the way it came has left plenty of hard feelings.
Well, Sue, the Archdiocese has made it clear it can't continue to support churches with few parishioners and fewer priests. But this maneuver is being taken as a slap in the face to the Lithuanian community, where many were actively campaigning to keep Our Lady of Vilnius open. Some critics are calling it the Cardinal's sneak attack.
Our Lady of Vilnius Roman Catholic Church is 102 years old, but the lock on the door is brand new. The archdiocese abruptly closed the church and changed the locks, allegedly while the pastor was in a meeting with Cardinal Egan. People showing up for 12:15 daily mass knew only what they read in the paper.
I think it's so unfair, especially the way it's been done. You know, you don't do that.
We had a good priest and the mass was good, and you know, we really need this church around us, especially for us working people.
The church, which sits near the entrance to the Holland Tunnel, was built as a national parish for Lithuanian immigrants.
Just last month, the Archdiocese announced a major reorganization plan which called for the closing of 10 parishes and the merging of 11 more. This church was not part of that plan, but was also slated to be closed. The Archdiocese has turned down our request for an interview, but has issued a statement.
It says Sunday and Holy Day Masses were regularly attended by 6 to 30 persons. The services were in English. There have been virtually no weddings or funerals in the church for years. Recently, Our Lady Queen of Angels in Harlem was also abruptly closed after parishioners staged a sit-in that ended in some arrest. Editors at the Catholic opinion journal Commonweal says the cardinal has a public relations blunder on his hands.
All of the goodwill that the cardinal built up in the run-up to this choice will be squandered. I think a lot of his priests are going to wonder why he did this to one of his pastors.
Lithuanian Catholics trying to save the church are hoping 3,000 signatures on a petition will help change the cardinal's mind.
Cardinal Egan, you're the only one who can save us. We appeal to you to reconsider your decision and reopen the church. Do the right thing.
Now, apparently, a letter hand-delivered from the president of Lithuania did not change the cardinal's mind. There are still two Lithuanian Catholic churches in New York, and they do offer Sunday Mass in the Lithuanian language, the Church of the Transfiguration in Maspeth and the Church of the Annunciation in Brooklyn.
Cerró las puertas de esta iglesia.
El cardinal Egan cerró la iglesia de repente ayer. Él llamó el pastor por una entrevista y entre tanto cerró todas las puertas, cambió los seguros.
Dichas acciones fueron repudiadas también por los miembros del capítulo Caballeros de Colón que auspicia la iglesia en dicha parroquia y que ahora también se quedan sin un lugar para reunirse.
All of a sudden, bingo.
Nos dejaron en la calle repentinamente, no podemos hacer nada, ni siquiera tenemos acceso a nuestras pertenencias. La Arquidiócesis Católica en Nueva York reaccionó a la polémica generada por el cierre en un comunicado por escrito, diciendo: La decisión de cerrar la parroquia había sido anunciada en enero 19 del 2007. Originalmente, la parroquia fue establecida para servir una comunidad grande de católicos inmigrantes en Lituania. Las misas diarias antes del cierre eran atendidas por un grupo de entre 6 a 30 personas. La arquidiócesis, sin embargo, no quiso responder preguntas directas sobre la polémica.
Pero estamos suplicando al cardenal para reabrir, porque amamos esa iglesia, es una iglesia chica, tenemos muchos lituanos, tenemos muchos americanos, tenemos una comunidad grande portuguesa.
El repentino cierre, aseguran estos feligreses inmigrantes de Lituania, hace el trago más amargo, según ellos, al recordar los malos tiempos bajo el régimen comunista, cuando cierres como estos eran la orden del día bajo ese régimen.
And this reminds me like communist times.
La situación me recuerda a los tiempos comunistas y no puedo creer que esté sucediendo esto en América. Los feligreses reconocen que el cardenal tiene la última palabra y esperan cambio de parecer no tan solo por los argumentos presentados, pero tras las súplicas constantes de los fieles, Patsy.
Vamos a seguir dándole seguimiento a esta historia. Gracias, Ricardo.